utmost protective shield. Cast rhodinium. This is the hardest substance known to our science. Lab theorizes an enveloping energy plasma, forcing an implosion.
Comments?
Obviously, their weaponry is superior to ours, and they have a practical invisibility screen.
You're discussing tactics. Do you realize what this really comes down to? Millions and millions of lives hanging on what this vessel does next.
Or on what this vessel fails to do, Doctor.
Yes, well, gentlemen, the question still remains. Can we engage them with a reasonable possibility of victory?
No question. Their power is simple impulse.
Meaning we can outrun them.
To be used in chasing them or retreating.
Sir.
Go ahead, Mr. Stiles. I call this session for opinions.
We have to attack immediately.
Explain.
They're still on our side of the neutral zone. There would be no doubt that they broke the treaty.
Attack without a visible target. How do we aim our phasers?
Aim with sensors. Not accurate, but if we blanket them, we can...
And hope for a lucky shot before they zero in on us.
And if we don't? Once back, they'll report that we saw their weapons and ran.
And if they could report that they destroyed us?
These are Romulans. You run away from them and you guarantee war. They'll be back, not just one ship, but with everything they've got. You know that, Mr. Science Officer. You're the expert in these people, but you've always left out that one point. Why? I'm very interested in why.
Sit down, mister.
I agree. Attack.
Are you suggesting we fight to prevent a fight?
Based on what? Memories of a war over a century ago? On theories about a people we've never even met face to face?
We know what they look like.
Yes, indeed we do, Mr. Stiles. And if the Romulans are an offshoot of my Vulcan blood, and I think this likely, then attack becomes even more imperative.
War is never imperative, Mr. Spock.
It is for them, Doctor. Vulcan, like Earth, had its aggressive, colonizing period. Savage, even by Earth standards. And if the Romulans retain this martial philosophy, then weakness is something we dare not show.
Do you want a galactic war on your conscience?
Captain DeBridge.
This is Uhura, Captain.
What's opposition?
Course unchanged, sir. Estimating treaty boundary in 21 minutes.
Are you continuing to broadcast tactical reports?
Affirmative, Captain.
And at this distance?
Approximately 3 hours before receiving a reply to our first message.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Check our course ahead, Mr. Spock.
A comet magnitude 7 dead ahead, and the intruder changing course toward it.
Comet Icarus 4. Composition?
Quite ordinary. An ionized mass, a trail of frozen vapor particles.
And when an object passes through it, even an invisible object...
It leaves a visible trail.
Ah!
Our chance, gentlemen. Prepare to attack. All hands battle stations. I hope we won't need your services, Bones.
Amen to that. Taking a big gamble, Jeff.